But what if for the live stream, instead of having that full screen, I want to have that like a lower third version, just, you know, maybe taking up that much of the screen. Or maybe I want to have like a picture-in-picture version, something like that. Well, presented by Church Tech U, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to reformat a full-screen image for a lower third on a secondary screen in ProPresenter. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I teach all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever had a situation where for one audience, let's say in person, you wanted a full screen version of an image, but for a secondary audience, like a live stream or a recording, you wanted that to be a lower third, go ahead and tell me about it in the comments below, and like, subscribe, and all that other fun stuff. So it occurred to me one day that while most of the time you might want a full screen version of an image, maybe sometimes you don't. Maybe you just want a lower third version or some other alternate size as opposed to full screen. So I thought that we would head over into ProPresenter and I would show you a little bit about how you could do just that. So let's head over right here, and let me start by going into my sermon here. Do I have a sermon that I've brought in? Looks like I have not. Maybe. Yeah, here we go. Okay, so imagine that amongst these slides, I've got a full screen graphic here. Let's see if I've brought that in. It is. So I've got this picture of Jesus. It's in the public domain. So when I click on that in person, I right-clicked on it and I changed under scaling to scale and blur. So that's how I got this blurring here, this drop shadow around it. That all happens automatically when you select scale and blur. But what if for the live stream, instead of having that full screen, I want to have that like a lower third version, just, you know, maybe taking up that much of the screen. Or maybe I want to have like a picture-in-picture version, something like that. Well, let's think. What would be a good way to do that? It would be great if I could take what is in one screen and smoosh it down. Well, actually, I can. So let's make a screen that will do just that. So let me go to more here and then theme editor. And let's see if I've got a sermon theme. I do have a sermon theme. So I've already done this here, but let me show you what I did. And that is I just basically click the little plus button here to create a new slide. And down here, I put this down here and I filled this with a color. Actually, let's do a gradient instead. So we'll go from this darker blue to this lighter blue. Maybe not exactly. Let's swap those. So that way, this is going to cover this up. Now I'm going to click up here and no, that does media. Silly me. I'm still getting used to these. If you're on an older version of ProPresenter, there's a big plus button. You click on the big plus button and then there are different things you can choose. But let's instead, I'm just going to grab a rectangle here. Okay, put that over here in the lower left-hand corner. And let's make it, I don't know, like that. Okay. Now, instead of filling that with the color, I'm going to go down here and let's go to a screen preview. And let's choose the congregation screen. Okay. So what's happening here is if I go up here to looks and go to edit looks and create a new preset right here, let's right click on look number two to rename it as image lower third. So you'll notice that I already have one, but we'll just do it like this. And now for my live stream screen, I'm going to go down to my sermon and let's create the one that I just did. And now we're going to click make live. Oops, real quick. Make sure that you uncheck things that you're not using here. Got a little bit of a visual glitch there. No biggie. But now I'm going to click make live. Okay. So now my congregation screen looks like this. And now my live stream screen. Do you like these videos, but you'd really like to learn from me in person? Well, I've got some great news for you. I am traveling around the country and maybe even around the world training churches on how to use ProPresenter. So I've got either a 1 or 1.5 day class that you can attend. For more details, head on over to TDM.fyi/events24, the top one right here, and register for the event nearest you. If there is no event that's near you, no problem, you can request one. So head on over to TDM.fyi/class request. That's this one down here, and you can say, hey, I'm interested in attending a class, or even I'm interested in hosting a class. Up to you which you prefer. In the last one, that is just information. It's not obligation, so don't hesitate to put your information in there, and I'll let you know when there's a class in your area, or we'll talk about what it takes to host a class. It's probably a lot less than you imagine that it is. So head over there, and I look forward to meeting you in person. Looks like this. Now, I made another mistake here. If I go back here to edit looks, because this is showing from the media layer, I do need to make sure that this is disabled here. So now, when I click save, we can see that on the live stream, it's down here in the corner with the bar underneath it for the lower third. For the congregation, it's full screen. Now, there's no reason why when I made that theme, I didn't have to put in that bar. I just did. So if I wanted to not have that bar, it would, in effect, be like a little picture in picture of the full screen. So that's something else that I could do. For this particular one, it is a vertical image. So let's explore some other possibilities here. So if I go to the theme editor and I'm just going to edit this a little bit. So first I'm going to get rid of this text box that I've added here. So if we go back to show mode, should be the case that when I click on it, yeah, that went away. So that's how it would look like a picture in picture. But let's see if we can maybe crop out the other stuff and just leave that kind of like a side image since this is a vertical image. So we're going to go back here into our theme editor, and let's make another one here under sermon here. And for this one, I'm just going to squish this over to the side. That's probably a good version here. Okay. Now I could tweak this a little bit if I wanted to, but I'm going to fill this. Check the little fill button. Again, go back to my screen preview. The congregation screen will be in here. And it should be the case that it's going to fill this basically from the center out. So in effect, it will crop the left and right hand side. So let's make another look. So new plus. Rename side third image. Okay. For our live stream, remember we're going to disable the media so that that doesn't show full screen underneath it. We're also going to disable the announcement screen because I'm using that for this, so we don't want to cover that up. Now I'm going to add my this guy right there, and now when I click make live, okay, so what that did was it did a scale to fit as opposed to a scale to fill. So let's see if we can fix that. That might be a little easier said than done, but let's just see here. Okay. Yeah, the screen preview image isn't wanting to let me do that. So trying to think if there's a good way to do that, and well, I could make this like this and squish it over like that. That's still gonna give me the blur on the side. Let me show you what I mean. So when I click on it, notice this blur on the side still exists. So I would have to figure out a way to crop that. So maybe some more work could be done, but you could see how if instead of using this scaling, if I had this scaling set to scale to fit here. So let's replace that here. And then I click on it, and now it goes away because there is nothing else there. So that would perhaps be a better way to do that. This way, we've got a good size version of the image. So even if someone is watching on a smartphone, it would be covering, you know, like a third of the side. And then you could have the pastor in this portion. So couple of different things that you could do, but that would be a great way to do it as well. So basically what you would do is you would just add an action or a macro to change to that particular look right here. And then when you went back to text, let's say that I had this text here, I would add a macro or an action to change to the regular sermon look right there. So that's how I would do that. So That is how you could have a smaller version of a full screen image for your live stream in ProPresenter, well, 7 or newer. If you like this content, you'd probably like my ProPresenter Quick Start course, so head on over to tdm.fyi/pro and quick. Give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you for free. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go out and change eternity.